We had the type of nights when morning comes too soon. Nothing was the same. Watch me going out of the way when I should have went home. Only time of the day I get to spend on my own. I was tripping off. I used to sleep at your crib. Should drive out right where you live and pick you up on the way. We ain't spoken so long. Probably.
Oh, what?
Come through.
What's that vibe like?
What's the vibe like?
Right? That is a vibe curator. Curator,
sure, yeah. That custom curate.
Drizzy.
Yeah, that's that custom curate come through.
That's come through by Aubrey Graham.
Drizzle? Or Drizzle?
That was theme music this weekend, mainly daytime. Because I was in charge of a lot of aux cords.
I think it control. Normally happens that way. You'll just jack it. Well, now it's a Wi-Fi thing. You'll just straight jack it from.
Yeah, they call me. Oh. Yeah, they call me Baby Bluetooth.
The Wizard of Wi-Fi.
Kid Connect.
Oh, that's funny.
Funny. That is a huge vibe. If you're sitting back and thinking, why haven't I heard that song in so long? That's Drake, Come Through, off
There's
of
no Come Through. Come
nothing
through.
Was the same.
A lot.
Very
Come Through. We'll be playing.
Very direct in what he wants you to do. He'd love for you to come through.
100%. I think I texted that a lot this weekend. It was a big Come Through vibe.
Huge Come Through vibe.
To a lot of just like, yo, yeah, come through.
Come through.
We're kick.
Yeah.
You don't even want to say kick mode anymore. You just got to like really shorten things in quarantine. I've been trying to shorten things anyways, but just we kick, come through.
Come through. What's
we're
Gucci?
Kick.
Catch this vibe. I've been telling a lot of people.
Should put out like a spotlight in the backyard. It's just like VL, like that. VL, you know what I mean? Vibe-like.
VL.
Vibe-like.
Oh, yeah, with that.
Right, like a Star Trek.
Yeah.
What's the vibe like? And that's what it says, like a bat signal.
Yeah.
This is just coming to me right now, and that's actually a really good idea.
That is actually a very good idea. We're going to document this. Luckily, this is documented.
What's the vibe like? There it is right there.
From across the club.
Rolling in like, yo, oh, JT's here. That's ridiculous.
You got to tell your boy that you just met with. You met three girls, and you – crazy vibes, but you need help.
Can you see me? I put my hand up. Well, where you at? What's the vibe like?
Look at the club.
The club.
I'm gonna go on record saying this is what I've been trying to figure out this week when describing the weekend to close friends that you know, a mm-hmm. Sam, a Gabe. A Chappelle. I think that might have been one of the best weekends I've ever had. It was so fun.
Oh, dude. Absolutely. That was wild. Looking back. And just big smiles, big vibes. Everybody in a good mood. Everybody got
hilarious
along.
Hilarious stuff. Huge laughter. But I'm trying to think if it's because of the perspective of not having anything, you know, and with the COVID situation.
Right. Haven't had a weekend like that.
And then that overexposure.
Mm-hmm.
But
that's probably something to do with it. But what does that matter? It was amazing weekend.
It was a crazy. But that weekend was nuts.
Yes. I mean, literally. Couldn't have really wrote it any better.
Could not have scripted. We're going to break it down, and we're still going to have to omit stuff. Because there was stuff that was...
That's how good it was. That's how good the weekend was.
There's it's a lot so good we can't tell you.
There's lawyers involved. No,
man.
That was wild. Wild.
So wild.
One of those things, it's also a type of weekend where it's almost like a really good trip where you don't even want to... People ask you what you did, and you just kind of say it was fun. But really, like, you couldn't really describe it unless you were there.
if you describe it to anybody, they're just like, no, so you're making half of this up.
Yeah. A okay, right. Stop, I'm done listening.
To put it in perspective, the weekend started with me chilling with Hootie till 1 a.m. Hootie
and the Blowfish.
Of the Blowfish.
Hootie. Darius Rucker.
Of Blowfish fame.
That is wild. I remember we were hanging out and you sent that picture of Hootie and I was like, what is going on right now? Is that actually Hootie and the Blowfish? And upon more investigation, that was Hootie and the Blowfish.
Well, you know why you didn't think it?
Sorry.
You know why you didn't think it on initial look? Because he looks great. Hootie looks great. I just want to tell everybody he's clearly been cutting LBs. I don't know if he's on a COVID diet or I maybe haven't kept up with him, but looks great.
I haven't kept up with him for the moment. I haven't seen him or thought about, not going to lie, or really thought about him in about a decade.
I will say we've been fortunate enough to run into a lot of people in our life and be around some cool people. In comedy, I've been around cool people. I'll tell you what, I was starstruck. I was like, dude, that's fucking Hootie, dude.
You really did. I mean, I'm not trying to be an asshole. It was cool, but you were like really, you were really, really blown away. I saw you that night and you were just like, dude, Hootie.
Well, it probably helped that he was cool as hell. Mm-hmm. And I don't think this is a weird thing to say about him. I think this isn't like illegal or something because it's illegal. I smoked a Jay Bird with Hootie.
Damn. You got that Blowfish going?
Yeah, I smoked a J. We shotgunned a J. No, I'm kidding. We didn't do that.
Really? Imagine. Jesus. Yeah, get closer. No, yeah, don't be scared of it.
He turned into a Blowfish.
That was really cool.
Yes. So, like, kicked it, dude. Chopped it up.
The visual. I just the visual of shotgunning a blunt with Hootie just made me laugh.
crazy. That was Thursday night. I know a mutual friend that knew Hootie, and she pops her head in this green room. So I'm hanging downtown at our friends Chappelle and Malik are hosting all weekend at Stand Up Live, and I'm in the green room with Brian Callen, Brendan Schaub were there. It was fun. Like, not to name drop too much, but it was crazy cool. It was fun to be around all those guys. They're good people.
Fighter and the Kid.
And, yeah, Fighter and the Kid, King of the Sting, all that stuff. And so we're chilling, and a mutual friend that all of us know pops her head in. She's like, hey, can my friend come in to the green room? And it's like, yeah.
You're like, come through. Yeah,
come through. Let me send you a Drake link. And the friend is Hootie. I love anybody that's like, hey, can my – it's like, can my friend come in? Your friend is – can Hootie come in?
Yes, definitely Hootie can come
Yeah.
in. Is he holding your hand right now?
Does he have a cracked rear view that he needs help with repairing?
can't see. He can't drive right now.
He can't see. Cracked. Yeah. Is he going to let you cry later? Probably.
Hootie.
So then I understand. I'm a big picture guy. You know that about me. And everybody's saying what up. And all I said to him, I said, go Gamecocks. Because I listen.
Get in there. Yeah.
And he's like,
your part.
This guy gets
something
it.
That touches his heart. Yeah.
So cool. It was just such a random 90s. Hootie and the Blowfish were massive.
As big as it gets.
Yeah. As big as it gets.
They were on top of the world there for a while.
That second Clinton administration, it was Hootie.
Everybody had that album. That was like,
oh, he was required.
94 or 95. That's like everybody had Dookie from Green Day. Everybody had that album from Hootie. Everybody had Alanis Morissette, Jagged Little
What's the Story, Morning Glory?
What's the Story, Morning Glory? Oasis,
Crash, and Dave Matthews Band, Crash.
You just had them. That's.
Did we have Crash? I remember. Have we talked about
under
this?
The
I
table
remember
and
having.
Dreaming?
I remember having before these crowded streets, which was. a Dark Dave album. I don't know why I had that album, but I think that explains a lot about my teenage years.
98, man. That's where I had it.
But so that was Thursday. So we were up till 1, hanging, drinking.
Yeah.
Vibing. And speaking of back to normalcy and stuff, that experience that night was we're just chilling in the green room. And I know you've been in some green rooms with me and stuff like that. Like, the green room vibes, if that night was so fun to me, I was like, I felt normal again because we're all just chilling in a green room. Like, seven comics just ripping into each other. Somebody letting somebody tell a whole bad story and waiting for the right moment to be like, so did anything happen? Did anything go down in that? And then... And then, you know, just blasting.
When you're telling the story, it's bad. It's bad on the other side too.
You always know.
You're seeing some faces, and they're all kind of like, are we going somewhere? Is the car in drive?
Right. Are you good? Is I'm good?
Did you just have a stroke?
So the green room vibe, though, that was like, that was so fun to do that. And it was like sensory overload. It was like, it was crazy. It was wild, and it was important to just, like, feel like human again.
Yeah.
And then Friday was the next – oh, and then Thursday night, we, me and you drank till 4, I think.
Yeah, well, we went to – I was at Evo, and then you came and picked me up after Hootie. You were on a Hootie high.
Hootie high.
We just went home and kicked it. Hadn't seen you in a while. So, yeah, it was fun. But, I mean, that began a streak of extremely late nights.
That was the beginning of the end. Yeah. And that rolled right into Friday. And Friday we
were hanging by the pool. We were just hanging, weren't we? All day Friday. Your show was at 10, so it was late kick.
Right. So that was the best thing about your guys' spot, though. You have a pool in Arizona. If you don't have a pool, I'm not hanging out with you between what's called May to September.
You can come to my house. It's not even rude to ask. Do you have a pool?
Yeah, do you have a pool? Because
if you have a pool, I have a pool. So
right.
If you don't have a pool,
so I'm not leaving.
Come through
to go to another pool.
I'm not gonna drive through to your spot with no pool.
With no pool, sands pool.
Sands pool. A sand pool. Different story.
You have sand and a pool. I thought you said sands pool. I will come through for sand.
I'm in. I'm on my way.
So that was clutch. Yeah, Friday pool vibes, and you guys were getting saucy, and Friday was definitely the day when I was stressed out about the show.
100%. I remember one time you were like, at like 6 o'clock, you were like, are you gonna make these burgers? I might have to leave. I was like, the show's at 10, don't you have to be there? Yeah, I'll get the burgers. But I can just tell you where.
I get that way. I sometimes don't get that way when I'm in a zone, but I'll tell you what, I haven't done comedy since May or March 9th or whatever. And
getting a ton of texts, a ton of all the show day. It's all hectic.
Show day is stressful because, yeah, you're getting people like, hey, can I come through and not pay? And you're like, in this economy, kind of need that Skrilla. But also, I understand some people are between jobs right now. Most people.
Right.
So
there's both ways where, like, I'd want to, I just can't. I want to come support.
Took care of a lot of people, but which was fine. I actually was happy to do that because then eventually I was like, we just need to have a fun night. Don't worry about the money, yeah. Blah, blah, blah. But a lot of people also, everybody that could pay did pay, and it mattered a lot. So I was able to definitely.
Couldn't believe I had to pay, by the way. I was a little upset. I almost didn't come.
Well, you know, I think that, you know, it all evens out.
That's $15. $2. Can you imagine? I do shoot you a text. Stay at home, bud. $15 is a little too
in between stuff right now.
Blood. Yeah.
But I was stress mode, and then I did a little different thing. So I did the PowerPoint thing up top, and so it wasn't like a normal set. I was like,
right,
talking through what happened the last like 3-4 months, which I thought was fun.
Very fun
to cover it and everything that's happened. So that was fun. And I also did that to cover the topics that are tough. So the comics didn't feel like they had to cover, you know, Black Lives Matter or, you know, the Corona stuff as much.
Right.
And I shed some light on it. And I think I made jest of it. some very serious
shine
stuff.
A light.
But that's my art. That's my art. And and people came through. So shout out to the people who come through.
Yeah, it was fun. We had some people over here made Turner Burgers.
Before. Yeah, you did make Turner Burgers.
And And then we were all just hanging. I haven't had, it was funny. I was thinking our crew is like, I mean, we get it rolling. I mean, and if, especially if we get it rolling at a pool midday, early day type situation, 10 o'clock was a little tough. We're feeling pretty good on this patio. And then we all had to order or to organize a
to make moves. Yeah. Yeah. I know that was probably tough. And I appreciate you always doing that.
100%. It was fun.
Ended up being fun.
It's just funny that, I mean, 10 o'clock for our crew is kind of a witching hour. It's really, it's more like turn o'clock because we're turning it up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, let's sure. get this thing really in gear.
Yeah. Our crew is very wavy in a way where if you do not catch this wave, if you don't catch this pocket, that thing's going to crash right on you, bud.
Right.
And,
get out of the way.
Because you can't hang. Because you got to hang. There's some boozy individuals
true.
In our crew. Some people that I think we should sit down and have a talk with.
Including myself.
Namely me.
Yeah. Yeah, that person's directly in the mirror somewhere. I look at him and say, what did you do? What's wrong with you?
So that was aggressive. And
then the show was great. All the guests were awesome. I've never seen Allie was a standout. She's
great.
Super funny. Yeah.
Really, super really funny. Yeah. She held it down on the back end. She's actually, if anybody's listening in Phoenix, she's back this weekend headlining because somebody bailed. And so they had her fill in to headline all weekend, which would be great.
At Improv or Stand Up Live?
Tempe Improv.
Okay, nice. Cool.
So you get a chance to see her do, I think she'll do, you know, 45, 50 minutes or whatever. Headlining
stuff.
Yeah, so she's great. And Trevor Wallace, my buddy, came out. Michael Blaustein. Who else is on that? Luis Alvarez is very funny from Phoenix. Audrey Stewart, Justin Elliott. And Jesse Jetski Johnson.
Jetski, she was great.
Of Kill Tony fame.
So she's one of my favorites. Just super weird in the best type of way.
Yes, 100%. And so and before that show, I showed up, and you know who was on stage before me? It was Sinbad. Speaking of 90s legends.
It's a toss back right there.
I saw Hootie.
He had Cracked Review.
I met Hootie and Sinbad.
Yeah. Yeah. You're meeting your 90s idols.
Crazy. So that was wild. And
how did Sinbad look?
Sinbad looked great. Sinbad looked great.
Sinbad looked great.
He did. He looked.
More
he
like
did
Sin
not.
Good, dude.
He's probably. He's got to be 60 something.
Yeah.
Because I don't think
he
was young.
Still? What was he wearing?
He was super chill. I think he had watched the Chappelle special. He had like shorts and a long. Sleeve shirt on, but still very funny. And he did like 2 hours by himself, no opening act.
Not easy.
Professional.
Yeah.
Type of comic where you're like, this guy understands what he's going on stage. So that was cool. And and then did our show. And then after our show, that's when things get, I think that was when the wave turned for
when
the weekend.
When it really got going, for sure. We turned the washing machine on at that point.
That was a heavy cycle too. Heavy load.
Yeah. You know, I think we've talked about this before. Our crew was that this whole weekend, kind of that washing machine feeling where it's going, you open the thing and it's still going. You can't really get your hand in there. You know what I mean? You want to get in there, but it's too dangerous to put your hand in. It's still spinning.
Yeah, sure. A lot of them have latches now that avoid that, but I know what you mean.
You know what I mean? Yeah.
Oh yeah.
We've all been there. Like, I'd like to reach my hand in there, but it doesn't seem safe. This thing's really going. It's making some crazy noises, actually.
And we were also, like, 14 deep or something at all times.
Yes. Big crew. Friday night, I mean, we were in the pool. It was thick. It got wild.
Well, you guys went back before me, and I had a bunch of people. Post-show Mike is one of my worst personalities.
You're not going to get an argument from me.
PSM, dude. I don't know what's going on.
Well, it's also
it's too much. Too much.
You have to do it. Yeah, it's also you can't just leave. You can't.
Yeah, talk to everybody.
But yeah,
you got to talk to, and then you're caught up talking to some people that you're like 3 minutes in with somebody where it's like you're a 1 minute person
or 30 second. What are we talking about?
Right.
We've never talked about this. I know you're not concerned with what you just asked me. I don't want to be disingenuous to you. So
thanks for coming.
Good to see you. It's really good to see you.
And then there's people, that I'm like, all right, well, we'll get drinks across the street. And so I went and got drinks across the street at a bar and you guys went home. So it was split. You guys had probably 10 deep back at the spot.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was,
distancing, but the whole way.
I was drinking at a bar for the first time in months. Well, we did it in Sedona, but still, this was like a bar with friends and stuff. It was like with a bunch of people that, you know, I had one of those big old hitters. 32s.
God. Where were you? McCallie's?
Devil's Advocate.
You were at Maloney's?
Maloney's, RIP Maloney's. Devil's Advocate, a classic Tempe haunt. And
Maloney's was the real one, though.
And so I was drunk enough to, like, do the let's all go back to John's place to, like, probably 10, 15 of us. And
all of a sudden, people were rolling through.
And we pulled up.
Mm-hmm.
That was rowdy. So we pulled up, and there was probably, there's 25, 30 people. Which
is by far the most people that we've had at this house ever.
Which is, and we get it, if you're listening and you're saying, this is pretty reckless with current times. I get that. But I don't know. I'm not interacting with any elderly people. I'm not trying to kill anybody. Beyond that, I'm being pretty responsible. There was nobody there that was 70. I can say that.
No, I felt 70 by Monday morning, but nobody in the crew was anywhere near of that age. But yeah, I mean, for the most part, we kept it to about 10 people, but late night Friday, it got a little hectic.
Late night Friday, we got in, there was a pool involved. There was people jumping in their bras and panties.
I did.
And it was really just special.
Well, first of all, it was. That was fun. That was a lot of fun.
It was very fun. And we drank till there was a huge bottle of Jack Daniels, as there has been the past several times that we've hung out. I don't know why. We've been on a big Jack binge.
Which needs to stop. I'll tell you that.
I don't mind Jack. I don't. That wouldn't be a thing that I think about getting a lot. You're pausing. What are you saying? Oh, Johnny hit the freeze on Johnny here. He's gonna come back with heat though. I think he's gonna come back with a perspective on Fireball, if I'm reading his facial expressions right. These Zoom meetings can be tough. What are you saying about Jack?
I don't mind it, but it's definitely not like. I don't know if we should be taking shots of it. You know,
ripping shots, right?
I would never be like out in any normal circumstances being like, well, let's get some Jack on.
And so we were drinking that, and that night ended up turning into what I remember is at sunset singing very loudly singing. I got a hold of the TV and I put on probably 4 or 5 Frank Ocean tracks.
Oh, that's right. Oh, God, now it's coming back. I do
in a row. And I will say one thing. I know sometimes my obsession with the Frank Ocean Blonde album can be annoying, but when the sun is coming up and you've been drinking all night, it's kind of a beautiful.
It is.
It was
a good choice.
It really is. Let the sun come up and play Godspeed and just let that one hit you.
There will be mountains you can't move.
Yeah. So shout out to the Blonde album. But, so then 7 a.m. It was a 7 a.m. morning.
Yeah, I remember bowing out, and you guys were like, sometimes if I'm up that late, I am in the mood. You're not even drinking anymore. You're just up and like, actually, it might be the fact that everybody's on the same level and you sound lucid and really introspective and like your thoughts are really together. It might not be that case, but some people are like really flowing at that time in the morning. You know what I mean?
Oh, well,
and you guys were talking about some really, I think it was just life stuff, but I was like, I'm asleep on my feet. I am going to bed.
Well, meanwhile, the dude that was talking about life stuff an hour before lost a freestyle battle to some chick that was one chick that none of us knew until this weekend.
What was she saying?
She was like new to town.
She She was saying, you know, you need to take a nap. She kept she saying was, nap.
She rhymed rap with nap like 7 times.
But she got him every time.
And still beat him. Because he couldn't about run, that. He literally couldn't say a sentence.
He couldn't put one punchline together. He would just be like, yo, oh, a nap? Whoa, shit.
Sometimes freestyle battles are the worst, but that was very
funny. Pretty good. I'm pretty quick. In one, I can think of a rhyme to go one step further, but then once I get there, what yeah. I thought out, I can't do it. Sometimes I can, but for the most part, I'll get to that end of that thing that I've already thought out, and then I'm like, I don't know.
So funny.
Hard to do. It's not easy to do.
People think because I'm witty that I'd be good at it. I am not.
I feel the same way. I can only do the first line.
Yeah.
And it's normally good. I can get you on the first one, but
it's gonna get you. That. It's gonna set you back.
Yeah. At least I have to. It's like in a fight, you gotta punch him in the nose, hit him first.
You lack follow through.
Right. Good starter, not a good finisher.
And then Saturday really was just drunk by the pool all day. And I think I was in a point where I had just done comedy for the first time in several months, and I was on a high.
Yeah, you were manic, I'd say.
You think manic?
You were, no, not actually manic, but reminded me of a face. I mean, you were, yeah, over the moon.
I was happy. Like, so filled with, what would it be, endorphins overload?
Yeah, you were flying, like, dude. You're flying high.
It was big like, smiles. And I think I'm still riding it. Like,
keep riding that wave.
I felt there's something about stand-up. My buddy Chappelle and I have talked about this over the break, where like we're so defined by the act of doing something, which is weird, but like, and it's also kind of scary because when that's taken away from you, you as a person have become so defined by that it's troubling to a degree, because on stage you're like expressing things in joke form, but you know, a lot of the stuff is like real thoughts that you've constructed to, you know, make people laugh, but also like true things that are within you that you're trying to express and connecting to human beings in a way that's like nothing I've ever experienced. And so to take it away is so like diminishing. And it's also probably, there's probably a lot of occupations that are like that. I just don't know a lot of occupations that, I don't know. I've done a lot of stuff, and I would say I've done a lot of drugs. I don't know a better feeling that I've ever had than like killing on stage. It's like a crazy, crazy high. And to have had that taken away from me for so long and then to do it again, and it went over well and everything was fine and it was good, was like a crazy rush.
Yeah.
That I've never.
It's a good feeling.
Crazy.
I think a lot of people are just like, yeah, not to that degree, of course, with a microphone in front of a crowd, but like I just miss, I get been down a lot, feeling down because I'm not, you know, able to go and interact with people.
Well, yours is, your job is all human connection, and that's what we're all about, I think.
Yeah, and so it's been a little hard, but it was nice to see you do your thing, of course, obviously, but just you did that for the crowd too on our end. It was nice to see that, to feel that feeling again, to be going out and like,
yeah,
together with a group of people. It was a good night. So I see why you were feeling good. Never apologize for feeling good, man.
It's crazy. So that was Saturday. Saturday, I was like, just
feeling. Saturday, we were, first of all, we're skipping over one of the, probably one of the hardest times I've ever laughed in my entire life. On Saturday, we ordered some pizzas to, seven cheese pizzas. And we were laughing about how that sounds like an order.
Well, imagine getting that call.
Yeah, and for sure you're thinking seven cheese pizzas. All right, this guy's, someone's throwing a birthday party for an 8-year-old. Like,
seven,
you
know, cheese pizzas. It's been there before.
Child's birthday party.
And yeah,
it was my roommate's birthday. Reddish. Yeah. It was his birthday. In fact, it was just his 31st birthday.
So yeah, we were laughing, imagining the dude on the phone at Hungry Howie's like, seven cheese pizzas, okay. How old's the little guy?
Tell me how old he is. Yeah.
tell me how old he is.
Give me an age, and I'll put the number and pepperonis on the pizza.
Yeah, let me guess. It sounds like a 9-year-old, but I don't want to jump the gun. Is he 10?
He turned 31 yesterday.
He's a 31-year-old man.
This man is in his early 30s.
Seven cheese pizzas. Should I throw in a little cupcake on there?
Okay, cake. So I can personalize that for you.
I could even write his name on there for the little guy.
I remember them at that age. They're the best.
You know what?
Oh, man.
Put the little rascal on the phone. Put him on the phone. I want to wish him. I miss my voice so much.
I can do a voice. I got a funny birthday voice. Yeah.
I do a bit. Let me sing Happy Birthday to him.
He'll think I'm Santa Claus.
Oh, that was probably one of the funniest. That was
so funny.
We were probably riffing on that for about an hour. Yeah, well, the whole week.
We had some friends over it was like two different crowds, two different groups of people. Like, well, everybody was friends, but you know what I mean? Some had never met before. And I think the two of them were just staring at us like, what? Like, they got it, but they didn't get it to the level that we were like, just, we were crying laughing.
I was crying laughing.
I don't know why that hit me so.
Seven cheese pizzas. How old is the little bugger?
Give me an age. It must be a big birthday.
If he's 11, that's easy. With pepperonis, I can just put a line of pep.
He's 31.
He's a 31-year-old male.
Who was in charge of that? Who ordered seven? First of all, seven cheese is actually fine. It was
perfect because sometimes you put too much thought into like the sausage, blah, blah, blah. Throw some pepperoni on one of them or something.
Come on, get serious.
It was Feds. Our buddy Feds is like a cheese guy.
East Coast guy. So he's like, it ain't pizza if it ain't cheese.
Yeah, it's just straight cheese.
But come on, throw some.
Seven cheese pizzas. Oh, I've heard this order before.
Big birthday.
I got some balloons in the back. I'll bring them
for this special occasion.
But and I won't even charge extra just for this one. I'm driving. You're lucky you caught me. I'll put a note on the driver's order.
Yeah, that was funny. But we were like, I think that just turned into like, yeah, we're just hanging by the pool, and then we ordered, I think, Chinese food. Did we get Chinese food?
That was me.
Yeah. Big move.
I thought
that was just a chill, fun day.
That was a solid move. At 8, we needed Chinese food.
That's the best thing about having a pool is you wake up. I woke up in my room, and I can just hear. You can hear the laughter. It sounded like a child's birthday party.
The sound of a child's birthday party.
No, there was. But you know, everybody. You wake up, come in the kitchen, look out, and everybody's just hanging in the pool. It's just fun, man.
Oh my God, that was such a fun day. And by the end of that night, we had some people coming over to crash, and then we're gonna wake up and go hit. And then we had, that was the crazy thing, is the next day was,
how
the next day
everybody
was actually
each other, like,
day.
What time are we getting up tomorrow? And the best is finding out, like, 8, if someone says 8, and you're like, oh, 8's not horrible. 8's, whatever, I can do 8. And they're like, no, we need to be there at 8. It's an hour, 15 minutes away. You're like, what's up? And at that, oh, man, so early.
So we had to wake up.
I'm a bit of a night owl.
Yeah, you don't have good hours.
No. Well, I mean, I'm good hours for not being up at 6 in the morning. I've never needed to be up at 6 in the morning. But
yeah. Yeah, you got that. That was a tough one because we were up at 7. I set an alarm for 6:30. Oof.
I was banking on it. What happened. You coming in to my room or someone.
With the Home Depot song playing.
Yes. The Home Depot theme was definitely playing.
The Home Depot commercial theme playing, and that is how you wake people up.
Sort of a dream state. You're just like, you kind of roll out.
This isn't real.
Throw some water on your face. Some sober people are there, and you're like, "What's it? Whoa? Who's driving?" you're like, "Because I'm not."
I had volunteered the day before to drive in a drunken stupor.
Did you actually?
I could have driven in the morning, but I thought I was best used as the DJ in the morning.
How about instead you drive and I'll blast the music as loud as possible?
And I think we played Usher Confessions Part 2
five times
in that road. Yeah. and you know what?
There was a bit of a divide in the van. We got one of those big vans, and back of the van was certainly
vibing,
leaning right back into the weekend vibe.
Which I think is the move. I would argue that you need to push it to the metal, push it to the limit.
Get right back to where you were.
Yeah, get back to even. Because once you start dipping, then getting back to even. I like to stay at even.
Right. I'm like
it's harder to get up if you lose momentum.
100%. I'm like AJ Green. If I'm even, I'm leaving. You know what I mean?
There it is.
I'm gonna be right there in front of the whole pack. Mm-hmm. Lead the vibe. Set the vibe. Don't feel the vibe.
And so, you know, I was just trying to do that through the art of 90s and early 2000s R&B. And
good job at it.
And I think I hit some tones. I think that the females were well represented. I played Monica. I played Whitney. I played Brandy.
Yeah.
I played TLC. I don't know if you remember playing Creep on the boat. But
That was once we got to the boat. The boat was... first of all, I've never been on the lake in Arizona.
Yeah, so we woke up.
First time ever.
6:30. We kicked somebody off. There was actually a 15th person that we had to say, "You're not going on the boat," which was hilarious, huh?
Did that happen? I'm only remembering that someone got on last minute. I can't remember.
Well, no, we left him at the house.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And then, and
you're off the island.
You know what? We've had actually a meeting as a group.
We've had a meeting outside 10 feet away from where you are. And we've decided that you're not.
So that was a hilarious way to start the day. And then, first of all, being violently hungover, like, look.
No one could count to 15. Do you remember that? That no one could count to 15? We were trying to figure out
who was there.
I couldn't get past 8. I couldn't get past the people that were standing in front of me.
Yeah. And But yeah, once we got up in that van, 15 person vans are very fun too. They can
with the right crowd for sure.
And that was a vibe. And then we got up there. Yeah, we're on a boat at 8:30. We actually did make pretty good time considering.
Oh yeah. And then boat life is just fun. You forget how much fun it is just to get out there. The wind's blowing. I had a windbreaker on, thank God, because I knew it'd be a windy day. And
it was 105 degrees and you had a windbreaker on.
It was fine though. I really wasn't like overheating by any means.
Sure.
But and then drop anchor, get in the water. Perfect day, man. Perfect day. And we brought the right amount of booze. No one, we didn't run out, didn't come close to running out.
And everybody knows what's important in that. Girl to guy ratio was, I think it was 14 people. We might have been sitting on 7-7.
I think you are correct. Yeah. We had the ratio was fantastic.
Could have been 8-6. I don't know.
I was, it was more of a boys' day for me. I was kind of mad the girls were there. I was like, who invited these girls?
We said boys only.
We said boys' day on Thursday. Boys only. What's going on? Who invited the girls?
They want to start a tiff.
Waking up, and I'm like, all right, well, they're not coming. So.
So let's kick the girls off.
Are we calling other guys or who's got guys on the phone?
Do they have brothers? Do any of you have brothers?
Because it is a boys' day.
And then we had 3-4 hours on the boat and cruising, and they did have a Bluetooth connect, and I thought everybody shared. I think everybody had there was like. Four of us, we all shared about 45-minute DJ sessions, and I think everybody really brought it. Did you jump on?
I don't think I jumped on.
Did I jump on? Grace, maybe then. Grace
was on it.
Grace is good.
The grace of God, she really brought it with some of
Grace
the
catches vibes. I owned it for about an hour. I played Maxwell. Huh?
Yes. Ascension. Ascension is essential in these COVID.
I was called. I think at one point you told me it sounds like you're driving alone in your car. But
well, sometimes it gets.
I will say sometimes that's how you got to approach it. That's how you got to approach DJ. Trust yourself, know yourself, know that you got good taste in music, and if you don't know this one, buckle up.
Yeah, you're about to learn something. This is Brandy's "I Want to Be Down with You."
We played Usher. We played. Obviously, Drake's "Come Through" was played several times, and
I couldn't figure out how to get my to float. I couldn't float, Mike.
Couldn't float.
I couldn't
get
my feet out of the water. I couldn't float.
You're talking about floating in the lake.
In the lake, I couldn't float. Yeah.
Oh, sure. I mean, I was fine.
I wasn't drowning, but I could literally. Everybody else is laying flat in the water, and I'm like, "What's going on?" could be
there was some thing. Assist- I think some though. People were cheating. There were some assistants here and there. There were some floaties.
Okay, that's true.
But you had to get your hips up.
I couldn't get my hips up.
You got to get your hips up. And
that became a theme as well. Everybody, even from the boat, yelling, hips up.
Hips
everybody,
up.
Hey, everybody, get your hips up.
And what we're talking about, if you don't know, is a back on a body of water, whether it be a pool or a lake, floating almost as if you're in the River of Jordan. Mm-hmm. And
or the River of Dreams.
Or the Black Sea. Black Sea you can float in, obviously.
I think that helps salt water.
Buoyancy. It's going to elevate. The density. Yeah, it's something about the density of – I don't know. I don't get that scientifically, but you can float there. But if you get
– Beautifully said. I don't understand. But it is a thing, and here we are.
I'll tell you who was the best floater we ever knew was our father, Jim Turner.
Float. I didn't get the gene, I guess.
You remember him just floating? I wasn't working.
Oh, yeah. Everywhere. And then just – it was like a fountain spitting water. It's a fool. But yeah, I couldn't get my hips up.
I have always questioned your hips. You've said you got bad hips. Don't you sleep bad?
I do have a bad left hip. Not that I sleep bad, but if I sleep bad, I get a little dysplasia there, like a German Shepherd.
Yep.
It hurts. It feels like it's come out of the socket. I should probably get that checked out.
I'll tell you what'll help. And I got one this year. You get yourself a nice new mattress.
Yeah, I sleep on a Tuck and Needle. It's a nice mattress.
Well, is it still hurt?
But no, first of all, it really doesn't happen a lot anymore.
Then it's probably the mattress.
It's probably the old mattress, yeah.
Because I used to not like the way I wake up. And now I went Brooklyn Bedding. Shout out to Brooklyn Bedding. Phoenix Brooklyn. Company.
Brooklyn in the house.
And game changer. Also, you know what I did just today? Got new sheets.
There you go.
I had newer sheets. I didn't like them. Too tough.
You know what? So before we get away from it, I do want to remember. So we're on the boat for about 4 hours. And then we get back to the van and we're like, well, we should eat lunch. First of all, it felt like I couldn't believe what time it was every time I looked at what time it was.
We got off the boat. It was noon.
I was like, it's noon? I'm like, I don't even know what I'm doing right now. And then drove down to this place called Dylan's. Or the little harbor marina area. And I just remember the looks that we were getting walking through there. One of the guy friends was wearing one of the girls' shirts.
He lost his shirt on the boat.
That's right. I remember circling back. Remember we circled back?
Like, it was done.
Let's go see if and we're like, that shirt is gone, sir.
Yes. He had a halter top.
A girl's shirt.
In a community in Arizona that is very pro, I saw several NRA shirts, let's just say.
Yes, very true.
And he's in a halter top.
And like Elton John sunglasses. It was a whole look.
I had the Elton John sunglasses with the yellow nanner. Right,
the yellow sunglasses, yeah.
And that was a vibe all day. People were really impressed.
Nanner. I ate a bagel, cold bagel, just cream cheese on it.
It's great.
Haven't done
that. You got to get a base.
It's like big camping. Base. Yeah, I had to eat something or I'm going to die.
We went to that Dylan's restaurant, and outside of that Dylan's restaurant was a slide that was simply titled H2 Whoa.
Which I was in 100% when I saw that. I'm like,
the H2, branding alone.
H2, let's go.
Oh my God. And so that was a slide, had three slides if you were like 10 or under, you had to take the little slide. Was that what the little slide was for? I don't know.
I think there were only two slides, but then there's one you could jump off of, like a little high dive.
But there was one that would shoot you. First of all, this thing was, what would you say, like 60, 70 feet long, this slide?
Yeah, it was a real deal slide. If you've ever seen a slide going into a lake. This
Google thing was, H2O.
Yeah.
Somebody out there, look up H2O.
As it gets.
And so one of them would send you long ways and one of them would send you straight up. And our buddy who had just turned 31 was running around like a 10-year-old who ordered seven pizzas.
Before that too, we're eating lunch. Before that, we're eating lunch and Michaela comes in with Jamie, our friend, and she's got a, like, her nose is busted, not busted, but it's like cut. She's bleeding at the nose. Yeah,
looked like she was dating Ray Rice.
Good God, what happened? She's like, the slide. And the first thing Michaela says is, wait till you see the other guy. Wait till you see Adam. And we're like, what? He's worse? He gets in there. He's even worse. They both.
And Adam's all nose.
They both had completely belly flop / face first into the lake. Just had no,
that's
no
how,
body control whatsoever.
That's how big the impact was on these. Mm-hmm. They I thought they ran into each other. The way mm-hmm. that they were bruised, that they looked like they had a broken nose or they had gotten into a fist fight. They hit the water so hard that they didn't break their nose, but like
it broke the skin.
And there's blood everywhere. I guess.
Both two people are bleeding from the slide. And then we're like, where's Reddish? And we're like, they're like, he's still going. He's
and Reddish did 20 things.
So I get up, then we decide to go. I'm following you guys out there. It's you and Reddish.
No, it's just you. Oh yeah. Yeah, that's right.
It was three of us, but there's only two slides, so
that's right.
You guys decide to go to at the same time. And the guy's telling you just some baseline. This is what you want to do for your head first. You want to bring your feet up and come in.
Chest up, neck up. And I was like, I got this.
Very dismissive. You're extremely dismissive. Like, I've been on a slide before. Thank you very much. And I got to watch you two go down. On the right is Reddish. And he executes it perfectly. Gets to the top, adjusts his body, comes in feet first, kills it. And I'm watching you. You went face first. And you are literally just like a flying squirrel, just hands going everywhere. You just looked completely. I was like, dude, this is bad. I was like, this is not good. I'm about to watch him like really hurt himself. And you hit face first, just belly flop, face first. And the whole crowd, which is filled with like 10 and 15 year olds, everybody just went, oh God. And I'm like, Jesus, are you okay? And you got passed.
It hurt immediately.
No, I'm sure. And then it made me nervous to go. I was like, "Jeez," because I mean, we were flying high at that point. Really,
we were drunk
good.
Enough where it probably didn't hurt
it
as much
hurt
as it would have.
A lot more, yeah. Had you do that sober, you're like, I think my day's over with.
Because I couldn't feel much, and then I was confident enough. I remember the second time, I was like, "Well, the stomach was aggressive, and maybe I shouldn't have done that." And so we did one more, and I said, "I'll go on my back." And I asked the guy, I said, what's different? I said, did you see me last time? He said, yeah, I saw you. Yeah. Everybody saw you. And he said, are you okay? And I said, not really. And I said, I'm going to go on my back this time. What should I do different? He just said, chin to chest. And I was, again, pretty dismissive. And I said, chin to chest. I got that. And I proceeded to do what I would say is the same exact thing from the backside.
You somehow turned yourself around and ended up landing on your front side again. It was
I landed on my back, but it was the same way as the flat. So I
when you got up there, you just started kicking.
I'll tell you what, we're sitting here 4 days after the fact. My body is still sore. My legs hurt.
My short, like I hit
my neck hurts.
Neck area, neck shoulder area, big time.
My whole body has been sore since that, but very fun.
Lots of fun. I remember I thought I lost my sandals. That was scary because I remember how hot it was on the deck. Like walking back to the car would have been insanely brutal to try and get back to the van. And I thought it was very funny that we got back to the van. These are three men in their mid-30s. And we had a van full of people who were probably looking at each other. We're waiting on three guys to get off of a water slide to head home. It's fun.
And we got back from that at like 3. And we ended up staying up till about midnight that night drinking.
Yeah.
And we caught more vibes.
Yes, we did. Big vibes.
And we played Codenames.
Codenames is a great game. That's one of my favorite games.
The one you got, though, I don't love. It's frustrating. I don't know why that's so different, though. It's just words, but it's like.
I think the frustration came from some of the captains. We're not as lucid.
Fair.
Yeah.
And some people cheated, blatantly cheated.
Yes.
But I will vouch for Codenames if anybody wants a good. It's not even really a drinking game. It's just a good. You can drink while you're doing it, but
right.
Great game.
Oh yeah, love it.
But yeah, that was the weekend. And then Monday, I was gonna go back, and I said I can't move my legs, and I did not leave Arizona till, I think, Tuesday. But
yeah, I couldn't. I was. That was a 2-day hangover. That was a very much so just like, wow, I need to sleep and drink water and rest. Feel better.
Great weekend, though. One of the best weekends on record.
Honestly, man, that was one of the best.
We've had some good ones, though. You know what is funny is we always have – it's always Reddish's birthday is the best – some of the best weekends of the year.
Yeah.
Because it falls in the middle of summer where you want to let loose a little bit. We usually go to Made in the Shade, though, which is
– right.
Always – those are boys' weekends.
NGA, man.
No girls allowed.
Maybe we could – that's the start of a new tradition. We could hit the lake next year.
Maybe that's what it is. Yeah. What a crazy weekend, though. And enjoyed it thoroughly.
Yes. It was good to see you. Good to have you out here.
Oh, yeah. Love you, brother. It was a very cathartic weekend, I think. It was much needed. And I know people out there probably thinking, geez, did you think about the virus at all? But there was moments, but I know that I needed that. And it's probably a little reckless, I guess. And that call me crazy, but I don't know. When we entered that weekend, what we did do is we didn't break any laws based on what the government of Arizona is saying is legal. And we were able to let loose a little bit, and
we broke a few other.
We definitely broke some
ones pertaining to the stay-at-home order.
Yeah, but it was much needed, and I wish everybody would have been able to experience a weekend like that. I'm sure there's a lot of people cooped up that have that maybe live with elderly people or are around people maybe of higher risk that can't risk that type of stuff. But I'll tell you what, I live with somebody in their late 20s. I'm 33 in tip top shape, as I would say.
I don't know, I saw you on that boat, but
I'm type O though, from based on a conversation I overheard somebody talking about a BuzzFeed article. I think I'm good.
Sounds concrete. So, based on something, a conversation I overheard about someone who brought up a BuzzFeed article.
I think if I got type O, I'm good. But there's like three people that got tested for COVID that we were around this weekend. So we'll see what those results come back. So maybe we're all fucked. But
yeah, I don't know.
At this point, I kind of want it just to get it out of the way.
I don't know how I feel about that. But yeah, I don't know.
But we're sitting about 4 or 5 days out, and I feel... feel good. I don't feel like
I feel fine.
Yeah.
I mean, on Monday, I thought I might die, but
yeah,
I feel fine today.
Weekend's good. Coming. Good weekend.
We got a mixer for the guitar, a looper.
It's got that's good. On it. I think we can use that for the podcast too. Let me see it.
Yeah.
What can you plug in there on the side?
It's got everything. Output, input,
aux. Maybe.
Charger, USB.
Does it have any XLR plugs or no? On the side? No.
No.
Whatever. But, well, that's fun. Yeah, because you're playing electric guitar now.
Yeah, it's fun.
And, I'm back to being a comedian, hopefully. Hopefully we'll be back in July doing another one. So.
Okay, cool. I'll set my calendar date.
Yes, do that. And, but either way, yeah, that was the weekend that was. I hope you guys listening and enjoyed us speaking on it. But that was a wild one.
Yes, 100%. Can't recreate that.
No.
That was just a huge vibe all the way through.
Shout out to Hootie. Shout out to Darius Rucker, who's a I consider a friend of mine at this point.
Close friend of mine.
And he did. He looked at me. He said, next time I'm out here, I'll look you up. We'll golf.
There you go.
I told him I golf.
And he called you Jeff. He's like, nice to talk to you, Jeff.
Good talking with you, Jeff. But, either way, we'll be We'll be back. We'll drop another one next week. We're back to Zooming. We did a couple in a row there where we were actually physically together.
Yeah, I haven't done this in a while. It's nice.
But love you, brother. God bless.
Love you too, man. I'll talk to you soon. Peace out.
A-Town down. Shout out to Drake.
Come through.